Please stand. Welcome to St. Dominic's Church for this celebration of the Eucharist. Today we are celebrating the 19th Sunday in Ordinary Time and the Feast of St. Dominic, our patron saint.
Holy Father Dominic, companion and friend of God, teach us the secret of life, to live in Jesus Christ, God's only Son. Flame that burns so clear and bright, lighting the way for the lost and the blind, leading them home to Jesus Christ, their true shepherd and God. Holy Father Dominic, companion and friend of God, teach us the secret of life, to live in Jesus Christ, God's only Son. Deeper communion with Jesus Christ our Lord. Holy Father Dominic, companion and friend of God, teach us the secret of life, to live in Jesus Christ, God's only Son. Companion and friend of God, teach us the secret of life, to live in Jesus Christ, God's only Son. May we treasure your heritage of common life in charity, of humility that's rooted in prayer, study and service to all. Holy Father Dominic, companion and friend of God, teach us the secret of life, to live in Jesus Christ, God's only Son.
Welcome, everybody, to St. Dominic's Parish, especially those who are visiting us. Guests, you are welcome. Today we are celebrating the Feast of St. Dominic. As per the liturgical calendar, the feast falls on August 8th. As we honor today St. Dominic, our parish patron saint. We seek his powerful intercession for all our parish community, so that we may grow under his patronage in love and unity, peace and harmony. Acknowledge our sins and seek God's mercy and forgiveness, so that we may become worthy to stand before his presence. Lord Jesus, you love us with an everlasting love. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, your mercy is boundless. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you feed us with your body and blood. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
And may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us sing the Gloria.
Gloria.
Sean, sing. Let us pause for a moment. And as we honor this great saint, St. Dominic, reflect how far progress that we have made being the spiritual community of St. Dominic, growing under the patronage of St. Dominic. Think the blessing that we have received through his intercession. The statue, the new statue we got 3 years ago, that reminds us that we are always growing in the presence of Jesus. Let us sing the Gloria now.
Glory to God, glory to God, glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace on earth, peace to people of good name. Glory to God, glory to God, glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace on earth, people of the name. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory, Lord God, heavenly King, O God, almighty Father. Glory to God, glory to God, glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace on earth, peace to people of goodwill. Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, of the world, have mercy on us. Take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Have mercy on us. Glory to God, glory to God, God in the highest, and on earth, peace on earth, peace to people of good will. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ. With the Holy God the Father, glory to God, glory to God, glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace on earth, peace to people of good will. Amen, amen, amen.
Let us pray. May St. Dominic come to the help of your church by his merits and teaching, O Lord. And may he, who was an outstanding preacher of your truth, be a devoted intercessor on our behalf through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the Book of Kings. Elijah went a day's journey into the wilderness and came and sat down under a solitary broom tree. He asked that he might die. It is enough now, O Lord. Take away my life, for I am no better than my ancestors. Then Elijah lay down under the broom tree, and he fell asleep. Suddenly, an angel touched him and said to him, "Get up and eat." He looked, and there at his head was a cake baked on hot stones and a jar of water. He ate and drank and lay down again. The angel of the Lord came a second time, touched him, and said, "Get up and eat, otherwise the journey will be too much for you." Elijah got up and ate and drank. Then he went in the strength of that food 40 days and 40 nights to Horeb, the mountain of God. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Taste and see, taste and see that the Lord is good, the Lord is good. Taste and see, taste and see that the Lord is good.
Bless the Lord at all times, his praise always on my lips. In the Lord my soul shall make its boast. The humble shall hear and be glad. Taste and see, taste and see that the Lord is good, the Lord is good. Glorify the Lord with me. Together let us praise his name. I sought the Lord and he answered me. From all my terrors he set me free. Taste and see that the Lord is good, the Lord is good. Look towards him and be radiant. Let your faces not be abashed. When the poor cry out, the Lord hears them and rescues them from all their distress. Taste and see that the Lord around those who revere him to rescue them. Taste and see that the Lord is good. They are happy who seek refuge in him. Taste and see that the Lord
reading from the letter of Paul to the Ephesians. Brothers and sisters, do not grieve the Holy Spirit of God, with which you were marked with a seal for the day of redemption. Put away from you all bitterness and wrath and anger and wrangling and slander, together with all malice. And be kind to one another, tender-hearted, forgiving one another as God in Christ has forgiven you. Therefore, be imitators of God as beloved children, and live in love as Christ loved us and gave himself up for us, a fragrant offering and sacrifice to God. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
I am the living bread from heaven, says the Lord. Whoever eats this bread will live forever. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. The people began to complain about Jesus because he said, "I am the bread that came down from heaven." They were saying, "Is not this Jesus, the son of Joseph, whose father and mother we know? How can he now say, 'I have come down from heaven'?" Jesus answered them, "Do not complain among yourselves. No one can come to me unless the Father who sent me draw them, and I will raise that person up on the last day. It is written in the prophets, 'And they shall all be taught by God.' Everyone who has heard and learned from the Father comes to me. Not that anyone has seen the Father except the one who is from God, he has seen the Father. Very truly, I tell you, whoever believes has eternal life. I am the bread of life. Your ancestors ate the manna in the wilderness, and they died. This is the bread that comes down from heaven, so that one may eat of it and not die. I am the living bread that came down from heaven. Whoever eats of this bread will live forever. The bread that I will give for the life of the world is my flesh." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
When I started reading this weekend's readings, when I started reading the first letter, the first paragraph itself, I couldn't control laughing. When I read, "Elijah went a day's journey into the wilderness and came and sat down under a solitary broom tree. He asked that he might die. It is enough now. O Lord, take my life." Oftentimes, brothers and sisters, we express our frustrations this way. "I have really had it. I can't take it anymore. The money runs out and the bills are still there. The marriage is breaking apart. We are very lonely and very tired of being lonely." And sometimes we say, "Yes, we are exhausted from carrying our burdens, and no one else knows that. And that is which drains us of our strength." You know, brothers and sisters, very beautiful reading, very apt, very fitting for us as we live in this today's society, as we confront all those kind of challenges, difficulties,
and problems. You know, when we face these feelings, we understand how Elijah felt. We resonate the same words of his. It's enough. Take my life. You know, and brothers and sisters, and when locked in this Elijah kind of feelings, what you and I can do? I don't think. The answer to this question is easy. And as a priest, you would expect me to say, a prayer, all will be fine. It is more complex than that, brothers and sisters. We need prayer. We need to seek God's guidance and his direction, how he leads us to different people, you know, to get a closer view of all that we are facing. To begin with, brothers and sisters, we need to get help. Whether that can be talking to a friend. You know, God, we can't carry it alone. God has not created you and me to carry everything alone. God has created us to help each other carrying our burdens. Sometimes that means, brothers and sisters, not only turning to a friend, but another who has the wisdom of professional training. And second thing, brothers and sisters, we must be good to ourselves. You know, none of us has the strength of Samson. None of us has the strength of Samson, nor the endurance of an ever-ready battery. No. Sometimes we ask more of ourselves than we are capable of giving. Yes, most of the times, you see, we keep doing a lot of things. We ask more of ourselves than we are capable of giving. We must take time for ourselves to reflect, to think, pause for a moment and reflect where I am heading to. What is the purpose, goal of my life? Why am I here? And as I said right at the beginning, finally, but certainly not the last, brothers and sisters, we need to bring our agonies, bring our pains to God. Jesus in the gospel said, I am the bread of life. And the one who is the bread of life is also the good shepherd. And it is the good shepherd who tells us, come to me, you who are heavily burdened, and I will refresh you. Don't forget that. Come to him with your problems, with your difficulties, all the issues, challenges that you face. He has assured us very much his assistance, his help. Come to me, all you who are heavily burdened, I will refresh you. Each weekend, we gather in this church. Every weekend, people all over the world gather in the churches. For what? For what? Is it because we are there to act together? It's not because of our act together, brothers and sisters. Of course, we would all say we are here to give thanks and praise to God for blessings, for the blessings that we have received and the blessings that we are going to receive as we move on in our day-to-day life. Yes, we need our batteries to be recharged each weekend. But the reality is that, brothers and sisters, people all over the world each weekend gather in the churches because most of us are broken. Most of us are broken. Most of us are suffering, brothers and sisters. Most of us are worried, oppressed, are in need or in pain. Precisely for that reason, people come. That's why The words of Jesus are very true, very apt. Come to me, you who are heavily burdened, I will refresh you. We gather in the churches, brothers and sisters, because we are humans. We are humans. All of us carry within us a little bit or a lot of Elijah. You know, we gather, brothers and sisters, every weekend because our life is fragile. And sometimes we just don't know how we are going to get from one moment to the next. Yes. Sometimes we just do not know how we are going to get from one moment to the next. And in our gathering, brothers and sisters, we come forward to receive the bread of life. The bread of life, the source of everything. We come forward to receive the flesh, Jesus the Lord, who gives his flesh for the world and for our lives. Yes, we come forward, brothers and sisters, to be fed by God. To be fed by God. Whose love never fails. Today, brothers and sisters, as we thank and praise God for the blessing that we have received, as we honor our great saint, our parish patron saint, Saint Dominic, great preacher, I was very privileged to grow as a seminarian under the patronage of Saint Dominic, where I did my philosophical and theological studies. Yes, and here I am, growing along with you under the patronage of Saint Dominic, who keeps interceding for all of us. Yes, we are here, brothers and sisters, to give thanks and praise God and to express all that we have in our hearts. For God is mighty one. He's powerful one, brothers and sisters. We need to ask, Lord, give us strength. When we are frightened, what we are facing in today's world, when we are frightened, what we face in today's world, Lord, give us strength, give us courage, lift us up with your mighty arms, for without you, we are lost. We are lost. Saint Dominic, pray for us. Mama Mary, intercede for us. And Saint Joseph, pray for us. Amen.
Kindly stand and profess our faith. I believe in God,
the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died and was buried, he descended into hell. On the third day, he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From there will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, forgiveness of sins, and the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen.
Amen.
Let us now place before the Lord our prayers in these petitions.
As we celebrate the feast of our parish patron, Saint Dominic, through his intercession, our parish community may be strengthened in faith and grow in peace and harmony, bearing witness to Christ's love and mercy. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For leaders and all citizens of the world who are called to be just and caring stewards of God's creation, and for those who feed hungry bodies, hearts and spirits, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For families that pray together and strengthen their bonds of love in this Eucharist, and for our seminarians and more vocations to the priesthood and religious life, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sick, injured, and hospitalized, especially those whose names are placed on our altar. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the spiritual and physical well-being of all parishioners, and for those who have died recently, especially Jacqueus Michael Lavascani, Vittorio Cantilano, Casimiro Pisoni, and for all who mourn them, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Pause for a moment and pray for our personal intentions. O God, who hast enlightened thy church by the eminent virtues and preaching of Saint Dominic, thy confessor and our father, mercifully grant that by his prayers we may be provided against all temporal necessities and daily improve in all spiritual good. We make these prayers through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Come to me and never be hungry. Eat this bread, drink this cup. Trust in me and you will not thirst. Eat this bread, drink this cup. Come to me.
Mass, we especially remember and pray for Casimiro Piccioni, along with the family members, for the repose of his soul. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of God's name, for our good, and of all God's holy church.
Attend mercifully to the prayers we offer you, O Lord, by the intercession of Saint Dominic, and through the great power of this sacrifice, strengthen by the protection of your grace those who champion the faith through Christ our Lord.
Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your heart.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For in the marvelous confession of your saints, you make your church fruitful with strength ever new, and offer us sure signs of your love, and that your saving mysteries may be fulfilled, that their great example lends us courage. Their fervent prayers sustain us in all we do. And so, Lord, with all the angels and saints, we too give you thanks as in exaltation we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna.
Holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness, make holy. Therefore, these gifts we pray by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, and spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, Thomas our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, Saint Dominic, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through our Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we now dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance to your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us now offer each other the sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Tell all my brothers about you.
I will sing as I
Let us pray. May your church, O Lord, receive with wholehearted reverence the power of this heavenly sacrament by which we have been nourished on the commemoration of Saint Dominic, And may your church, having flourished by means of his preaching, be helped through his intercession, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Prayer to Saint Michael the Archangel.
Saint Michael the Archangel, defend us in the day of battle.
Be our protection against the wickedness and the snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And to thou, Prince of the heavenly host, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who prowl through the world seeking the ruin of souls. Amen. Pray to Saint Joseph. To you, O blessed Joseph, do we come in our afflictions, and having implored the help of your most holy spouse, we confidently invoke your patronage also. Through that charity which bound you to the Immaculate Virgin Mother of God, and through the paternal love with which you embrace the child Jesus, we humbly beg you graciously to regard the inheritance which Jesus Christ has purchased by his blood, and with your power and strength to aid us in our necessities. O most watchful guardian of the Holy Family, defend the chosen children of Jesus Christ. O most loving Father, ward off from us every contagion of error and corrupting influence. O most mighty protector, be kind to us, and from heaven assist us in our struggle with the power of darkness. As once you rescued the child Jesus from deadly peril, so now protect God's holy church from the snares of the enemy, from all adversity. Shield too each one of us by your constant protection, so that supported by your example and your aid, we may be able to live piously, to die in holiness, and to obtain eternal happiness in heaven. Amen. Saint Joseph,
pray for us.
Saint Dominic,
pray for us.
Wishing you all a very happy feast of our patron saint, let us all give thanks to the Lord for all the blessings we have received through his intercession. Yes, dear family, parishioners, I thank sincerely for all that you do directly and indirectly for your church. May God bless you all, always. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Thank you, Sean, for the beautiful music. Thank you all the ushers and everybody who are part and parcel of this parish. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in the peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
O Lord my God, when I in awesome wonder consider all the worlds thy hands have made, I see the stars, I hear the rolling thunder, thy power throughout the universe displayed. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee, how great thou art. My soul, my Savior God, to thee, how great thou art, how great thou art. When through the woods and forest glades I wander and hear the birds sing sweetly in the my soul, my Savior God, to thee, how great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee, how great thou art, how great thou art.
when Christ shall come with shout of acclamation and take me home, what joy shall fill my heart. Then I shall bow in humble adoration and there proclaim, my God, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, how great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art. My soul, my Savior God, to thee.